thanks for sticking around. You're still watching Arrive 360, and I'm your host, Kachi Ofio. Well, it is time for a review of the hottest stories that came out of the music industry as we look at this week's music news. So this is exciting. The first set of Grammy performers have been announced for the awards show on the 10th of February at the Staples Center in Los Angeles. Now, Camila Cabello, not surprisingly, will be one of those making their performance debut at the show, as well as being nominated for Best Pop Solo Performance for Havana and Best Pop Vocal Album, Camila. Well, Cardi B again would also be taking the stage, as the rapper is also nominated for Record of the Year for I Like It, Album of the Year for Invasion of Privacy, Best Pop Duo Performance with Maroon 5 for their hit song Girls Like You, as well as Best Rap Performance for Be Careful. While other artists set to be performing are Post Malone, Shawn Mendes, Janelle Monáe, and Kacey Musgraves. And then, of course, the legendary Mariah Carey has filed a lawsuit against her former assistants for breaking a non-disclosure agreement, as well as blackmailing her. So Liana Azarian, who served as Mariah Carey's assistant from 2015 through November 2017, had secretly filmed Mariah engaging in personal activities which, if had been released, would have personally been embarrassing and professionally damaging to the singer. Well, evidence against Azarian suggests that she had threatened to release or sell the footage unless Mariah Carey paid her, while the We Belong Together star will be suing for at least $3 million in damages. And her assistant is also counter-suing, claiming that she was subjected to physical and sexual abuse, which included being urinated on. Not good. Well, Rihanna is taking her father, Ronald Fenty, to court in the United States. She is accusing him of exploiting her name to further his entertainment business. So Rihanna claims her dad and his business partner have falsely suggested that she is connected to their firm, Fenty Entertainment. Now, her legal claims comes from the fact that their conduct has misled the public and, of course, hurt her Fenty fashion and makeup brand. Fenty Entertainment, which advertises itself as a talent and production company, was founded in 2017. So the lawsuit asks the court to order Ronald Fenty to stop using the brand name, and then it seeks damages, which will be determined later. So for Drake fans out there, you need to know that an unauthorized documentary of the Canadian rapper is currently streaming on some selected regions of Netflix, as well as on Amazon and iTunes. However, the film does not include any exclusive interviews from Drake himself. It features his rise to the top from contributors such as Rolling Stone editor Joe Levy, Professor Jason King, Kathy Landoli, and some other people. Now, it follows his early childhood through his TV career and then his jump to music. This documentary is titled Rewriting, or rather Drake, Rewriting the Rules. Meanwhile, the rapper himself has inked a deal with XS Nightclub in Las Vegas, but has yet to release the official dates. What this means is the Sin City Club audience will be seeing a lot of the rapper throughout the year. And then music streaming app Tidal, owned by mogul rapper Jay-Z, is coming under fire. So its streaming figures are currently under investigation in Norway over claims of numbers of listeners to 2016 albums by Beyoncé and Kanye West, amongst others, being inflated. So the Norwegian authorities said they would explore whether someone, in quote, had manipulated the figures but did not name any individuals or companies. They also said, that is the Norwegian Authority for Investigation, that the move would have led Tidal to have paid disproportionate royalties to the singer's record companies at the expense of other artists. Well, Tidal's lawyer, however, says the platform is not under suspicion. And then Korean pop band BTS, oh my gosh. Well, they have a documentary film, and guess what? It is moving to YouTube this week. Well, it had its cinematic release last year. It did so well. It is called Burn the Stage, the Movie. And it offers a behind-the-scenes look at the band's 2017 Wings Tour, which drew more than 550,000 fans in 19 cities around the world. YouTube Originals announced a documentary will be released on the site on Friday. But that's not all. Diehard fans can also look forward to the band's new concert film, which is set to be the largest ever event release in cinemas upon its release at the end of the month. Well, January is definitely going to be a fun month. What's also making it interesting is the fact that this Las Vegas-based rockers called The Killers tackled racial conflict and gun crime in America in their new song, Land of the Free, and it is buzzing everywhere. So the band teamed up with director Spike Lee for the accompanying video, which saw Lee travel to the U.S.-Mexico border, filming numerous families as they tried to enter the U.S. The track questions the U.S. prison system, gun control, as well as border control. And of course, The Killers frontman Brandon Flowers also issued a statement on Twitter in which he cites Ava DuVernay's documentary 13th and Jimmy Kimmel's monologues as having a big impact on his political thinking. Well, Land of the Free is out now, and you can always check it out.
Can't wipe the wind-blown smile from across my face. It's just the old man in me washing his truck at the Sinclair station in the land of the free.
I feel like I'm loving the song already. Well, after all that music, you see, let's turn to the online world right now and check out social media. You know what it is? It is time to let you know what's trending. But you see, this one is a bit of a controversy. So civil rights advocate and legendary soul singer has announced that she will be singing the national anthem at the upcoming Super Bowl on the 3rd of February. So this decision has come with major backlash as some question her stance on the NFL's treatment of Colin Kaepernick. Now, we don't need to go straight into that history because nobody likes it. Well, in response, Gladys Knight acknowledged the footballer's protest of police violence and injustice, but she felt like the distinctive senses of the national anthem and fighting for justice should stand alone. As someone who has been in the forefront of the battle for equality longer than those voicing their opinions currently, she stated that her decision to sing the anthem will give it back its voice. Well, hopefully this might just reduce the amount of pressure on the halftime show's performance. Well, away from that, 2018 was definitely a great year for Ariana Grande. And it looks like 2019 is just, you know, getting ready to be another massive year. So the singer has released her new track already called Seven Rings, after about a week of teasing fans with photos on Instagram. Now, while her last single, Thank You, Next, was a song dedicated to her ex-boyfriends, Seven Rings is an anthem for friendship and flexing. The lyrics mostly involve buying expensive things and is an ode to the My Favorite theme song from The Sound of Music. Now, within minutes of releasing the song and video, Twitter erupted, not surprisingly, with many people tweeting that they suddenly felt very poor because of the extravagant lyrics. Now, the song is currently at the top of the US iTunes chart, so at the moment, it looks like Ariana Grande can do no wrong. But you see, it's all right, Ariana, we still love you regardless. Now, it is time for another quick break. But you really need to stay tuned to the show. Coming up, I'll have my best bits of the comprehensive end of the week review of the best art stories. Now we're talking arts and culture. Stick around, we'll be right back.